हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो आई एम बैक विद द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर क्लास ट्वेल्थ पोएम, थर्ड पोएम कीपिंग क्वाइट बाय पाब्लो नेरुदा। वी हैव ऑलरेडी रेड दैट पाब्लो नेरुदा इज एम्फेसाइजिंग ऑन द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ इंट्रोस्पेक्शन। ही फील्स दैट व्हेन वी डू नॉट स्पीक एनी लैंग्वेज, व्हेन वी डू नॉट मूव आवर लिम्स सो मच एंड वी सिट फॉर मेडिटेशन फॉर सम टाइम, मे बी इट वर्क्स to clean ourselves, because through meditation, introspection, we get to know about our follies and then we are able to work upon our weaknesses. One more thing, he says that maybe through the meditation time or at the time when we are sitting for introspection, we won't be doing anything, and this way maybe the laborers also get some time of break. Because otherwise they are always busy in earning their lives and they never want to get even a single break, because they feel that they lose money that way. But here through meditation at the time of introspection, they will get to look at their own hurt hands. Now we start with the second part, those who prepare green wars. Now first of all, if you get this line as RTC, your question can be, who are these those? Those who prepare. Those here means, it is referring through this word those, the politicians and scientists. Okay, he feels that these politicians, these scientists, for their own benefit, sometimes they aggravate wars. Okay, so this is what those. So those who prepare green wars, he says, sometimes some people are indulged in green wars. Green wars means war against nature. War against nature means those who are doing or spreading pollution, who are causing pollution and wars with gas. Naturally, some people are having the factories where they make chemicals. Then wars with fire. There are certain factories, okay, where ammunition is made. Though maybe he feels that all these people who are the owner of these factories, they earn a lot of money, but the thing is that whatever product comes out, sometime if this is not used in a right way, it can cause trouble for the humanity. Okay, so naturally, like first of all, green wars, pollution is bad for this earth. Then gas, wars with gas, chemicals, there are incidences of acid attack. Okay, so naturally, if this is not used in right way, then wars with fire, maybe ammunition is needed by the armies of a nation. But what about those terrorists who are having this ammunition, guns and all these things? So this way he feels that there are many people who suffer because of all these things, these kind of wars. And then what he feels more, victory with no survivors. He says actually, whatever product we get from all these factories, the fact is that there will not be anyone left, there will not be anyone to survive and to enjoy the victory if we do not pay heed to such things. Maybe he is here referring to especially green wars, pollution. Because if there is pollution and if there is no control over pollution, what will happen? One day this planet will be a dead planet. And if the planet is dead planet, actually you cannot expect anyone to survive on this planet. So this is what he means to say, that all these wars are actually bad because as a result there will be no one to enjoy the victory on this earth. So that's why he says that this work also should be stopped for some time, and all these people, all these laborers who are working in these factories, they should get some time to introspect. They would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade. He says they should also get some time to introspect. Then they will change the uniforms and they will wear the normal clothes, and then naturally they will be out of the feeling of those factories also when once they change the uniform. And then they will get some time to spend with their own brothers and sisters and enjoy nature. In the shade means maybe in some garden or under the shade of the tree, they will sit and chat with their own people, and then they will introspect. So this way maybe there will be a kind of healing touch. In what way healing touch means? Doing nothing. He says this way, if these people, they stop their work and they do nothing, actually doing nothing will be a kind of healing touch, because they will not be preparing anything which can be misused, and this way maybe it will be a healing touch for the whole humanity. When what I want should not be confused with total inequity. Now he says, though I am trying to tell this thing only, I am spreading this message only, that there should be some kind of meditation time, some kind of introspection time, we should stop our work for some time. But he says, that does not mean I am talking about stagnation. Actually, what is stagnation? Stagnation, one example I can give, you will understand what is stagnation. You know, when we talk about stagnant water, we say naturally there will come larva on the surface of the stagnant water. Okay, stagnation is always taken in a negative way. Stagnation means when you totally stop your work. Okay, so this is stagnation. But he says, no, I am not talking about that stagnation, when you stop your work. He says, I just want that you introspect, you meditate. Okay, it's not that I say just there should be just, you know, enough of these factories and now there should be no factories at all in the world. No, he says maybe these things are needed, but there should be some introspection behind each and every work which we do. So that's why he says, my message should not be taken as if I'm talking about total inequity, as if I'm talking about stagnation. He says, no, I'm not talking about stagnation. Why? Because even I know that man should keep walking ahead. Okay, one should not stop forever. But he says, life is what it is about. He says, I know it very well, that life is an ongoing process. Life is what it is about. In Hindi, I think you might have heard this word, chalti ka naam gaadi. He says, even I know this very well, that life is an ongoing process. Okay, one should keep on doing the work. I want no truck with death. He says, the only thing is that I do not want to be associated with death. He says, I have nothing to do with death. No truck means no association. He says, I am not talking about death. I am not promoting death. He says, I just want to give this message only, that one should give some time once in a day for few moments of meditation and introspection. If we were not so single-minded, now first of all, underline single-minded. Single-minded means selfish. Okay, sometime he says that we become very selfish and we start thinking about material progress. Okay, and we sometime forget that our maybe spiritual progress is more needed, but rather we start searching for material progress. So we become selfish for that. So he says, if we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving, he says this happens, that sometimes we just think about our own lives only. We just think that we should keep on amassing wealth, we should keep on progressing. We forget to talk or think about the whole world. So he says, sometimes this happens in our lives. And for once, could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt this sadness. He says, actually, when we become selfish, the sadness enters into our life and we do not even know about it. If we know about it, naturally we will stop it. But the thing is, we never get to know and the sadness enters into our life. We start becoming more and more sad and we do not know the reason behind it. So what can be done at that time? He says, at that time, if we do not do anything, for once could do nothing. He says, so if we do not do anything and just we welcome a huge silence in our life, means for once we sit for meditation, we become silent, we do not speak any language, maybe in this silence, through this introspection, maybe we will get to know about our own mistakes. Okay, then only maybe we will get to know that yes, maybe I am sad because I had become selfish. Okay, he says, then only maybe this silence would give some good result. Okay, because we would get to know about our own mistakes. might interrupt this sadness of never understanding ourselves. He says, actually this happens, that we do not understand ourselves. Sometimes we forget that we are social animals. We need society. So becoming selfish maybe will not give any purpose, will not solve any purpose. So he says, maybe then only, through introspection only, we will understand, which maybe otherwise we do not understand. Okay. And that's why he says, when this sadness enters in our life, okay, and we do not understand the reason behind the sadness, okay, never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. He says, we sometimes fail to understand that this sadness actually threatens us with our life. Means this sadness will bring more and more maybe sicknesses in our life. We will become depressed, and depression means maybe ailments, and ailments means we will be very near to our death. So he says, because of actually selfishness, we threaten ourselves with death. And how can this be averted? If we become silent for some time and we introspect, and maybe through introspection only, we will get to know that where we were wrong. So he says, maybe this way introspection can help. Perhaps the earth can teach us, as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. He says, now in the ending, he says, maybe the same lesson we can take from earth itself. Maybe earth is also teaching us this lesson. And what is this lesson? That what happens on this earth, that sometime it seems that there is total annihilation. Means sometime because of the autumn season, you feel that yes, there are less trees, or there are less leaves on the trees, the trees have gone dry, and maybe no life is left. But this lesson we get from earth, that when the right time comes, when the spring season comes, then again we see the sprouting, then again we see the green leaves on the same dry trees. So this way we get to know that yes, when the right time comes, everything comes back to its life, everything will flourish. So he says, this way we can get this lesson from earth, that if we become silent for some time, it doesn't mean that we are heading towards death. No, maybe rather we are heading towards a new life, that life which will be full of happiness. That's why he says that earth can teach us, as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive, in the spring season life comes back. Now I will count up to 12 and you keep quiet and I will go. So again he says that yes, once in a while, once in a day, you get some time for introspection, and then you will get new life. So nutshell in Hindi, I think you have already understood. But here in this poem, poet kya kehne ki koshish kar raha hai ki kuch time hum apni life mein introspection, atmanirakshan ke liye lagaye. हम जब खुद को जानने की कोशिश करते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं हमें पता चल जाएगा कि हम कौन सी गलती कर रहे हैं और किस गलती की वजह से हमें क्या नुकसान हो रहे हैं। यहाँ वो उसके फायदे पहले बताता है कि अगर हम मेडिटेशन करेंगे, इंट्रोस्पेक्शन करेंगे, कोई लैंग्वेज नहीं बोलेंगे, तो कहीं ना कहीं शायद झगड़े भी कम हो जाएंगे, क्योंकि दुनिया में बहुत से युद्ध जो हुए हैं वो लैंग्वेज के बेसिस पे हुए हैं, लैंग्वेज के कारण हुए हैं। तो शायद वो कहता है हम इन युद्ध से भी बच सकते हैं। फिर कहता है अगर हम थोड़ी देर अपना काम रोकते हैं तो शायद जो मजदूर पैसे के लालच में रोज काम करते हैं, थक जाते हैं लेकिन अपने पे ध्यान नहीं देते हैं, शायद वो भी जब मेडिटेशन करेंगे तो उनको भी थोड़ा आराम का टाइम मिलेगा। फिर वो बोलता है कि बहुत तरह के युद्ध में लोग लगे हुए हैं, कोई फैक्ट्रीज में केमिकल बना रहा है, कोई गन बना रहा है, या कोई ट्री काट रहा है, अच्छा फर्नीचर बना रहा है लेकिन नेचर को हार्म कर रहा है। कहता थोड़ी देर मेडिटेशन होगा तो ये काम रुकेगा तो शायद लाइफ कहीं अच्छी और हो जाएगी। लेकिन फिर वो कहते हैं ये सब चीज़ों का मतलब ये नहीं लेना चाहिए कि मैं चाहता हूँ या मैं ये कहने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ कि इंसानों को डेड की तरह हो जाना चाहिए, डेड पीपल्स दे शुड बिकम, कि बिल्कुल कुछ ना करें और बिल्कुल मुर्दा लोगों की तरह पड़े रहें। कहता नहीं, मैं ऐसा नहीं चाहता हूँ, मैं ये बिल्कुल नहीं कह रहा हूँ कि स्टेग्नेशन हो जाए, इतना भी काम नहीं रोक जाना चाहिए कि उसमें से बदबू आने लगे, नहीं, अपने काम को चलते रहना चाहिए, आप आगे बढ़ते रहो, काम करते रहो, लेकिन थोड़ा बीच बीच में रुक कर इंट्रोस्पेक्शन करो, मेडिटेशन करो, और आपको पता चलेगा कि कभी कभी जब आप सेल्फिश हो जाते हो, सिर्फ अपने लिए सोचते हो, तो ऐसे में आप अपने लिए ही दुख तकलीफ और मौत को बुलावा दे रहे होते हो, क्योंकि बहुत सी बीमारियां आपको घेर लेती हैं आपके अकेलेपन की वजह से, जो डिप्रेशन आता है कहता। लेकिन अगर आप इंट्रोस्पेक्शन करोगे तो आपको पता चल जाएगा कि आप कहाँ गलती कर रहे हो। और आखिर में पोइट कहता है कि धरती जो है हमें यही एक लेसन ये भी देती है, धरती भी अपने काम को कुछ टाइम के लिए रोकती है। जब पतझड़ का मौसम आता है तो ऐसे लगता है कि सारे पत्ते ख़त्म हो गए हैं और ऐसे लगता है कि धरती बिल्कुल सारा नेचर बहुत रेस्टिंग टाइम पे चला गया, रेस्टिंग पीरियड है उसका। कहता वो नेचुरली शायद नेचर को भी रेस्ट लेना ज़रूरी होता है ताकि वो स्प्रिंग टाइम में एक नई लाइफ दे सके दुनिया को। कहता ये हमें इस अर्थ से, इस धरती से भी शिक्षा लेनी चाहिए। आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस पोएम। नाउ जस्ट गिव 2-3 रीडिंग्स बिकॉज दिस इज लिटिल बिट फिलोसफिकल, सो गिव फ्यू रीडिंग्स, यू विल सर्टनली अंडरस्टैंड। थैंक यू।